Telescopes are unable to view exoplanets directly. These planets are hidden by the bright glare of the stars they orbit. Consequently, astronomers use other means of detecting and studying these distant planets. Scientists search for exoplanets by observing the effect these planets have on their stars. A planet-containing star does not orbit perfectly around its center. When viewed from far away, this star appears to be wobbling due to its off-center orbit. This method has led to the discovery of hundreds of planets. As a result, only planets larger than Jupiter can be seen in this way. The smaller Earth-like planets are more difficult to detect, since they create only small wobbles. The first exoplanets were discovered only about 2 decades ago. The number of known exoplanets has doubled about every 27 months ever since. Over 4,000 exoplanets have been discovered and are considered confirmed. However, there are thousands of candidate exoplanets awaiting further confirmation. A bright spot can be seen in the equatorial constellation Virgo, 57 light-years from Earth. There is a yellow dwarf star called Gliese 504 that belongs to the spectral class G, much like our Sun, and has a mass equal to 1.22 solar masses. But what gets the most attention is a planet called JG504b that orbits this star about 8 times as far as Jupiter is from the Sun, about 43 astronomical units. The planet is poorly lit by its star at such a distance, but its upper atmosphere has a temperature of about 237 degrees Celsius. In part, this can be explained by the young age of the exoplanet, which is only 160 million years old. The solar system as a whole is 4.6 billion years old. JG504b is estimated to be 4 times heavier than Jupiter. Data from 2016 shows that it has a radius of 0.96 that of Jupiter. Due to its scorching temperatures, it wouldn't be a very enjoyable place to visit. Nevertheless, researchers are still interested in this lightweight body. It's one of the lowest mass exoplanets found using direct detection methods. In our solar system, there is no massive body at such a great distance from its star. As planets jostled in a young planetary system, a collision could have thrown the pink exoplanet out into its current orbit. However, planet formation is an evolving field, and this is just one possible explanation. An object 43 astronomical units from its star would take more than 100 years to complete in orbit. This exoplanet may be even farther away from its star due to its orientation relative to Earth. The planet was discovered as part of a larger survey called the Strategic Exploration of Exoplanets and Disks with Subaru, which examines star systems of varying sizes and ages with images taken at near-infrared wavelengths to understand how planetary systems form. This is one of only 5 or 6 exoplanets whose presence has been directly observed by a telescope instead of inferred from observing stars. And here comes the interesting part. The planet is pink. Using the Subaru telescope in Hawaii, researchers were able to directly image the pink gas giant in a new study announcing its discovery. This blushing planet has less cloud cover than other exoplanets, which means researchers can peer even deeper into its atmosphere to determine its composition. If we were to travel to this giant planet, we would see a world glowing from the heat of its formation. This world would have the color of a dark cherry blossom, a dull magenta. Do our minds wonder what gives planets their colors? The exoplanet is not a source of light. Instead, it reflects it. The light they reflect, however, does reveal remarkable colors. Planets can be a wide variety of colors depending on a range of factors. In the case of gas giant planets, their colors may be related to weather effects in their atmosphere, such as clouds on Venus. Or it may be related to the gases themselves, as on Jupiter, Uranus, Neptune, and Saturn. Because of the high percentage of water on the surface, the Earth appears blue-green from space. In the case of planets with little or no atmosphere, we can see the color of their surfaces. Mercury is a rocky gray, while Mars is a butterscotch red. This exoplanet is located outside the conventional area in which planets are expected to form, since it lies far from its star. A mechanism called core accretion describes how dust, rock, and ice in the disk of material around a young star collide and stick together until a solid lump grows to the size of a planet. The exoplanet's orbit could also provide further clues as to its formation. A very eccentric orbit, or one that is not circular, would support the scattering hypothesis. There are many different kinds of exoplanets, which is why it is crucial to gather as much information as possible. High contrast imaging, the technique for detecting exoplanets directly, could help with this. Several telescopes coming online in the next year or two will be even better at picking up the faint glow from exoplanets. JG504b is a colder, bluer world than astronomers anticipated. The near-infrared camera reveals that its color is much bluer than other imaged planets, which may indicate that it has fewer clouds in the atmosphere. Although it is the smallest alien world ever captured on camera around a sun-like star. Scientists say the exoplanet's features challenge the core accretion model of planet formation. Based on this widely accepted theory, asteroids and comet collisions produce planets like Jupiter, and when they become massive enough, the gravitational pull attracts gas from the gas-rich disk of debris that orbits the young star. But this model doesn't explain the formation of planets like JG504b that are far away from their parent star. This is one of the most difficult planets to explain from a traditional planet formation framework. Its discovery implies that we need to seriously consider alternative formation theories or reassess some of the assumptions underlying the core accretion theory. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.